So kick back, get your popcorn ready. We'll be back in just a moment. Happy holidays, everyone. Welcome to our coverage of the NBA on 2K Sports. We'll watch the Boston Celtics in this one as they go up against the Memphis Grizzlies. And along with Grant Hill and Doris Burke, I'm Brian Anderson, joined by Allie LaForce, our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Well, we've really seen Jaylen Brown coming on for the Celtics. In times in the past, he had to fight for minutes in their crowded wing rotation. But he signed that big contract extension in 2019, and he has responded. He said, quote, "There are going to be highs and lows, but guys, through all of it, he tries to keep an even keel."
All right, Allie, thank you. And checking out the opening lineup for Memphis. Kyle Anderson is out there with Jonas Valanciunas. Then it's Dylan Brooks. Then there's Tyus Jones. And it's Allen in at the shooting guard position. And for the Celtics, Brown and Tatum are the wingmen. Daniel Tice is out there with Tristan Thompson. And it's Smart in at the one. Grant, you are the master at meshing with your teammates. How key is being on the same page early in the year?
BA, it's critically important that everyone get on the same page early. I felt like when I played and a new team was assembled, it was important to connect off the court. Those connections, that relationship, I'm a strong believer, carries over onto the court. So meshing, becoming one as a unit is critical for that success of that team.
Well, chemistry counts, doesn't it? Out left to the wing. Just five on the clock. From deep three-point range. And it's Brooks missing. And here's Boston. Pass to Tatum. Puts up a three. Knocks down the triple.
This guy is a sensational shooter. It doesn't take a lot of separation for Jason Tatum to put it in the basket.
And here's Allen. On the wing, Brooks. Here's Valanciunas. The shot off that time. Now the Celtics take it the other way. They're getting their first look of the season at the Grizzlies in this one.
And they swept the team last season, got the upper hand, and sustained the momentum.
Well, a year ago, there was a big gap in talent between the two teams. But changes are always made, and we'll see how they match up this time around.
And that one, good.
Well, Jaylen Brown has a ton of upside, and he shows it with his passing ability there.
Offensively, it's been a struggle for him.
Yeah, they need to string together some shots to have any kind of chance.
Brooks, the pass to Valanciunas. Here's Anderson. And the miss, not the best shot selection there. Here's Smart. He played a great game against Indiana. Pass to Tatum. Thompson with a screen. Tatum can't hit.
And he probably thought he was going to bury that one.
Left side, Jones. Here's Anderson. Allen with it. Now Jones. Here's Anderson. Off target from three-point range. Boston has gone 1-for-2 from beyond the arc in this first quarter. Thompson in the post. Blocked!
Boy, that's the length of Jonas Valanciunas on the defensive end. Not easy to get a shot over the seven-footer.
Pass to Allen. And there's the foul. It'll go on Tristan Thompson. That's his first foul. Timeout called, the Grizzlies. They want to keep rolling here, following the win against Brooklyn.
They were really able to exploit that defense. I mean, getting almost any shot they wanted. It was that easy.
Give them some credit. I'll tell you this. They caught an opponent on a very off night defensively, and you take advantage. Simple as that.
And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first. Pass to Anderson. Sinks that one after missing his first two attempts. Now 1-for-3.
gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
Boston, no good that time either.
Given his range, you'd expect him to capitalize on that opening.
Pass to Brooks. And there's the call on Dylan Brooks. That's his first foul of the game.
And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
Here's Smart. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in this first quarter. Thompson finds Tatum. And he'll draw the foul. He'll head to the line for two. It's going to be on Dylan Brooks.
Watching Jason Tatum use his footwork to create separation is a thing of beauty. Jab steps, pull up, step back, fall away. He's got it all, guys.
First free throw is good. You know, Doris, the other thing about Tatum, he looks more decisive now to me, which coupled with the footwork is a lethal combination.
And to me, B.A., that's simply about repetition, about getting more comfortable in the NBA game. He is rifling through decision makings, his reads becoming quicker, faster, sharper. This guy is such an extraordinary talent.
He's off on the second.
Well, how about Jason Tatum's rookie season? In the heat and the crucible of the playoffs, this guy rose to the level of the pressure. Incredible.
The Celtics have gone 2 of 6 from the floor. Now here's Smart. Here's Tice. And here's Jones to the right side. Valanciunas with it. Looking for his first basket still in this one. There's the block. Smart outside. Pass to Tatum. Drills it from deep.
Jason Tatum's form is pure on the catch and shoot. So nice.
Memphis has gone 0 for 3 from downtown. Now Allen, out to the wing. Here's Valanciunas. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. It's on Daniel Tice. First one falls.
The 5th overall pick back in 2011, Valanciunas has worked so hard to improve his entire game. I'll tell you, it's paid off, Kevin. He can impact a game in a lot of different ways.
So he gets them both. Here's Tatum. He had a big outing in that Pacers game as well. Pass to Brown.
Well, being aggressive and assertive, the big man snatching the rebound.
Here's Anderson. Valanciunas down low. He's against Tice. And off the left side of the rim, it swirls in for him.
I think we know Jonas Valanciunas is effective inside, but he's got an opportunity and ability and the touch to drain jumpers.
Now here's Smart. Pass to Brown. Played it in with a nice touch off the window.
This guy, a tough cover for any defender. Creative and assertive, scoring the ball.
High post, Valanciunas. Down low, Allen. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line. knocks down the first one. And the Grizzlies with some changes. Jang, he's checked in for Valanciunas. Clark comes in for Anderson. And it's Ja Morant in for Jones. That's also good, so he hits both free throws.
An efficient night from the line. This is a guy who puts in the work and it pays dividends.
Brown finds Tatum. To the paint. Here's Tice. Nice D from Allen.
That's the shot you hope for. Right at the rim. Just couldn't capitalize.
Tatum gets the bucket.
Wow. Some strong perimeter shooting here in the first quarter.
Outside Morant. Clark outside. Back to Morant. Over Teague. And another miss by Memphis.
And this is exactly what you have to do to stop him. That was a tremendous contest, forcing the miss.
Pass to Ogilvy. Brown, a screen on Clark. And the Grizzlies making a change here. Melton's checked in. Outside, Williams. Here's Teague, driving in. It's rebounded by Memphis.
Boy, in that close, he's almost automatic. But boy, that's pretty good defense. Wow.
Williams against Morant. That one goes. Now he's one for two.
And the advantage he has is clear. Just taking what the defense gives him right there.
Boston has gone 3 for 5 from deep so far in this matchup. Williams with the screen, with the drive. Pritchard gets it to go.
Want to score in the NBA? Picks can really force the D to make tough choices.
The Grizzlies have gone 3 of 9, struggling so far. Outside Morant. Now T. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Now here's Williams. Teague attacking. Left side Williams. And there's a whistle. That's going to go on Brandon Clark. That's his first foul. Against Morant. Again, Boston.
The mid-range game of Jeff Teague is on point. Doing work, sir.
Memphis trailing here. Trying to find a spark here.
Yes, indeed. A rough stretch offensively. They could really use a basket.
Well, this has not been a quarter to remember for this guy. He looks completely flustered.
To the middle. Here's Williams. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up.
And even from where we're sitting, you could clearly tell it was a foul.
And the first one at the line is good. And so he's able to get one of two. And in 2019, Gorgui Jang was a recipient of the offseason NBA Cares Community Assist Award. for his great work in his native Senegal.
Yeah, BA, there is so much to unpack there. His father was a mayor in Senegal, so from a young age, public service was ingrained in him.
Just three to shoot. Here's Ogilvy. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Teague. Moran against Williams. A chance to push it to double digits, but it's off the mark. Memphis has gone 0 for 4 from deep to start this one. Williams against Moran. Looking to end the drought. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair. And you know, Grant, it's amazing to think that coming out of high school, Morant wasn't even ranked by the major recruiting services.
And what's really funny is that his college team, Murray State, actually discovered him by accident. One of the team's assistant coaches went to a camp to see a different player. Of course, Morant fell in love with the school's community during his visit and committed on the spot, canceling his official visit to South Carolina.
Anderson's checked in for Memphis. And that trip coming up empty, missing both. The Celtics with the lead. Inside. Williams passes to Teague. That one goes in. Teague's got his second bucket of the night.
What a way to begin this game. Dominating at both ends of the floor.
And give them credit for approaching this game with the right energy and intensity.
Ooh, that was something else,
I mean, just
man.
Beautiful. Playing from behind, it's amazing he chose a dunk with that high a difficulty rating.
Yeah, no question. That was a stellar move with plenty of swagger. And here's Teague. Excellent D there from Morant. And that concludes the first quarter of play. Celtics out in front, up 9. And we'll be back in just a minute with the start of the second quarter. And earlier, we checked in with Marcus Smart, who told us how his upbringing helped shape his approach to the game.
I'm the youngest of four boys. So as anybody who has siblings, older, younger, you understand the struggle, especially being the youngest. You know, you always got to fight for what you want.
And no question, Smart is considered one of the toughest guys in this league.
You love his passion and his willingness to sacrifice his body for the team every night.
We welcome you back to second quarter action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. All right, guys, what do you think about the Celtics here in this one?
The aggressiveness on defense has been infectious. Everyone's come to the party. I love it.
Well, I think they combined great intelligence with great effort, and you can see the results.
On the court for Memphis, Dylan Brooks is out there with Kyle Anderson. Then there's Ja Morant. Then there's De'Anthony Melton. And it's Valanciunas in at the five, roaming the paint. Here's Morant. Here he goes. That one's good. Makes him 3 for 7.
I like that decision right there. Don't try to force a shot inside. Kick it out.
And we played through the first minute here in the second. Smart outside. Pass to Brown. And Jaylen Brown gets a whistle that time. That'll be a second foul of the game.
And this kind of selflessness is great to see. Textbook positioning to draw the charge.
Allen, he's checked in for Melton. Here's Anderson. From deep, Morant. The shot, no good. Boston has gone 3 of 5 from the perimeter in this game. Brown passes to Tice. And finished off by Tice.
I think Brown demonstrating he's got a great understanding of the game. He keeps his head moving, his eyes open, so he can spot the open man.
On the wing, Brooks, pounded by Tatum. Takes a 13-footer, and it's Brooks missing. The Celtics have gone just 1 of 3 to begin the second quarter. And it's good for 2. Boy, in terms of global influence, Grant, it's amazing to see how popular the NBA has become all over the world.
NBA, it's incredible how this game has grown and had the influence all over the world, as you said. I mean, I always say the NBA is an amazing global marketing and public relations firm. And to be able to sell and market the talent of the players and teams on a global stage is incredible. Hey, even you and I, we could go anywhere in the world and people are going to know who we are because of our association with the NBA. How about that?
I'll agree with half of that statement. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
Last season, Brad Stevens became the 5th coach in Celtics history to reach the 300-win milestone. He joined some legends, but he said, quote, "I don't stop and think about that stuff. We've had really good players and an ownership and management that lets us fumble occasionally, too. I just appreciate where we work." Guys, Coach Stevens, always humble.
All right, Allie, thanks. That free throw, no good. The Grizzlies making a switch here. Jones is checked in. Good on the second one. Now a timeout called by Memphis. And as the coaches draw up their strategies, the players staying hydrated with some Gatorade. That's key to keeping them at their best all the way up to the buzzer.
It really is. And every one of those players knows it. They're all making sure to stay hydrated. It's impossible to play your A game if you're not getting enough to drink, especially towards the end of games when the physical toll of a long contest really starts to add up.
And we're just over 2.5 minutes into the second. Pass to Allen. Over to the left wing. Clock at 6. Here's Anderson. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair. It's on Daniel Theis. Now, Grant, you were involved in a sign-and-trade deal from Detroit to Orlando, but you don't see that tactic as much anymore.
You know, you really don't, B.A., but there's a reason for that. First and foremost, players today have a lot more control over their destiny. And also, teams are not going to wait until an elite player is in their final year and they don't have a firm commitment and belief that that player will re-sign. In a lot of cases, teams will trade that elite player before he enters his last year of his deal, for fear that they may lose him for nothing in free agency.
Second free throw, no good. Well, here's Tristan Thompson playing out his 5-year deal. He signed with Cleveland in 2015. Doris, he was sought after in free agency this past summer.
Well, it's easy to see why, B.A., right? This guy is not young any longer, but he's got a ton of playoff experience. He's a veteran who can help you both on the rebounding and defensive aspect of the floor, both critical to long-term success.
Rejected! Jones with the ball. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Pass to Anderson. Nice. Gets his second bucket. He's 2 for 4 now.
Great timing and coordination. Lays it in coming off that pick.
Now Smart. Pass to Brown. Wide open. Valanciunas with a rebound. Valanciunas has got four rebounds in the game. The Celtics have gotten just 2 of 6 field goals to go in the second. And they're going to count that bucket, and they'll send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Boy, I just love how Marcus Smart plays the game of basketball. He's aggressive, he's intelligent, and he doesn't mind getting under your skin.
On the wing, Brooks. Pass to Valanciunas. And there's the rejection. Outside, Brown. No good on the three. Memphis has gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. Allen, the pass to Valanciunas. Back to Allen. Jones with the ball. Now here's Allen. Second shot opportunity, and it goes. As the official calls the foul, count it, and he'll shoot one more at the line. For Boston, they've gotten 5 of 8 attempts to drop since the second began. Outside, Brown. Basket counts.
Well, you have to admire how Smart is running this offense right now. He has a knack for spotting open teammates.
And Memphis shooting just around 33% since the second quarter got underway. Pass to Anderson. And the foul is called. He missed it, so he's got a couple of free throws coming his way. It's going to go on Tristan Thompson. And he makes a first. And Grant, since the conclusion of your playing career, you've spent the better part of a decade covering the game on television. So what's been your favorite part of that aspect of your career?
You know, B.A., it's been incredible. I mean, I've enjoyed every aspect of covering games. And I think for me, it's being so close to the action, getting a chance to almost get lost in the game, feeling like you're in the game as we get a chance to watch these amazing athletes go up and down the court. It's the closest thing to actually playing, being right here next to you, calling the games.
And great makeup, too, Graham.
Always. We all know he's a good shooter, but from that distance, I don't think so.
Boy, we're seeing it more and more. Guys looking to create additional space by stepping back further from the line.
With the step back, Jones. No good off the back of the rim.
Boy, he was wide open. You wonder, did he overthink it? That's a missed opportunity.
Teague, no good from outside. Memphis has gone 0-for-2 from outside in the second quarter. Pass to Jones. Back to Brooks. Here's Anderson. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Driving inside. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
The officials were right on top of that one.
Falls for him.
He does a great job of drawing contact and getting himself to the line, something he didn't do in the first period.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. He's perfect from the line this time. The Celtics with the lead. Here's Teague. The rebound by Melton. Well, the Grizzlies shooting at 30% here in the second. Pass to Jang. Here's Anderson. Five to shoot. Fires the three. Pure from three-point range. Melton's gotten himself on the board with a three there.
Well, he showed right there. This guy capable of making shots, especially if you leave him that wide open.
And he's going for the oop here. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Williams.
That's a perfect example of why good hands are important in basketball. Just misread that pass completely.
Morant, he's checked in for Memphis. Here's Melton. And here's Memphis now. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. To the inside. Shot blocked! Here's Ogilvy. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. On the take. Williams from long range. No good that time. And the Grizzlies going the other way now.
Well, you think about the 22nd pick in last year's draft. That is Grant Williams and his addition to the Boston Celtics. And his mentor is Marcus Smart. And consider strong, tough, fearless, similar styles of play. So it was a natural combination.
Outside tee. He's off on that one. Morant with a defensive effort.
I'll tell you, he's trying to help them extend this lead, but it's been a tough night for him individually.
To the middle. Here's Jang. Second chance effort. And the layup is good. And it's now only a one-point Celtic lead.
Well, the definition of an effort player. Jang shows off that high motor, converts off the glass. Nice.
The Grizzlies making a switch here. Brooks has checked in. You know, much like Smart, Williams is a versatile defender. Doris, he can switch on to almost any position.
B.A., once Williams got used to the speed of the NBA and comfortable with his individual assignments, this guy became a force for good. He's so smart, excellent feel for the game. He should have a long, prosperous career.
Shot clock at six, and that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. Clock is at three. Late clock. The Celtics got to hurry here. Boston, no good that time either. Here's the Grizzlies with the ball. They're on a 16-5 run. Here's Morant. Ooh, it's stolen away. We've got 1:13 left in the first half. Pass to Pritchard. Into the lane. Williams. And a nice finish on the layup. And the Celtics lead by three.
Have to love the ball distribution. Keep everyone involved.
Here's Jang. Brooks outside. Pass to Jang. Picked it out of midair. 35 seconds left to play in the second quarter. Sinks the tray.
Slow reaction from the D, and it cost them three.
Memphis has gone 1 of 3 from three-point land here in the second quarter. Here's Jang. Williams defending. Three-pointer, Brooks. Fires in the triple. Brooks has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three.
This is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Well, that three-point shot just gives you so much room to operate on the offensive end.
Here's Teague. It's deflected.
Oh, the 7-3 wingspan erases that shot. Nice by Gorgui Zhang.
And so a close game as we wrap up the first half of play. It's the Celtics. They're up by three. And time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And we hope you enjoyed the competitive first half of action. Ernie Johnson here welcoming you back to the 2K Sports Halftime Show. That guy right there is Shaquille O'Neal, and that guy right there is Kenny the Jet Smith. It was all Jason Tatum in the first quarter. He had 13 points and 3 rebounds. And taking a look at the Celtics, Kenny, what did you see out there?
The passing is what kept the offense rolling. The communication has been tremendous. Guys are working as a unit and not as individuals. They've got to repeat that kind of ball movement in the second half.
And Shaq, let's get your input on the Grizzlies.
You know, they haven't shot the ball very well. Not nearly enough quality looks. Right now, this game could easily come down to shot selection and how they run their offense. They need to keep the ball moving and generate better looks.
And it's just about time now for the third quarter to get underway.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. And you know, Jason Tatum, he's been really making it happen, guys.
You just love his patience offensively in the first half. Waited until he got the looks he wanted.
You know, as a coach, you can preach good shot selection, but it's up to the players to execute, and this guy has done just that.
And in that first half, we saw a pretty tight battle. We'll soon find out what sort of adjustments were discussed during halftime. Brown and Tatum are the wingmen. Tristan Thompson is out there with Daniel Tice, and it's Smart in at the point. That's who's in the game for the Celtics.
Yeah, he's looking to get on a roll here to start the second half.
And I've got to believe that was something they talked about during the break. Get him some good looks into the paint, get into the heart of the defense. Beautiful.
Back to Brooks. Allen against Brown. Allen attacking. And the dunk by Valančiūnas.
This guy came over from Lithuania with an ability to play pick-and-roll basketball, and he's only gotten better during his time in the NBA.
Tatum passes to Brown. Thompson, a screen on Allen. And here's Brown for three. And again, Boston with the triple.
I'll tell you, he'll take that all day, every day. I'm sure he was shocked to find himself that wide open.
To the left wing. For three, Allen. Rebound Boston. Tice has got 6 rebounds now in the game. Boston has gone 5 of 12 from three-point range tonight. Driving to the basket, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Valančiūnas. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
And just incredible timing and defensive awareness. I mean, when you face a defender that can reject you like this, it can alter your entire approach.
Memphis on D. 6-point game. And it's Smart missing. Right around a minute and a half played in the third quarter. Back to Jones. Over to the wing. His first shot coming late. Offensive rebound. Oh, he muscles it in through the contact. They call the foul, and he's on his way to the line.
That'll drive your coach crazy, failing to box out.
And to me, this is a common theme that's running through the league right now. Guys looking to leak out rather than box out.
Grant, almost every night in your career, you drew the toughest assignments on defense. What makes a great wing defender in your eyes?
Well, I mean, obviously, I think you have to have certain tools. You know, you have to have the ability to move your feet. You have to have athleticism. But really, ultimately, it's about desire. You know, I always feel that guarding perimeter players and being a great wing defender is a lot like being a great rebounder. You know, you can talk about technique and this, that, and the other, but at the end of the day, it's about heart, it's about desire, it's about doing everything possible to compete on the defensive end against great offensive players here in the NBA.
Ooh, Thompson with the block.
That's where Thompson's length comes into play. You think you can sneak a shot over him, but he'll swat it right back at you.
Outside Tatum. Inside, Smart right side, beyond the arc, the basket's good, off the assist from Thompson. Smart has got 8 points.
The three-pointer becomes a very high percentage shot when he's that wide open. You better get a hand in his face.
Brooks against Tatum, a leaner, knocked away. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Now here's Smart. Tight defense on him. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Did you ever notice the physicality? That's an aspect of Marcus Smart's game. He just powers through the defense. Sensational shooting.
And it's the Grizzlies with the ball. They trail by 9. Pass to Allen. On the wing, Brooks. Third quarter of basketball here. A little under 3.5 minutes gone by. 6 on the shot clock. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. It's on Daniel Tice.
I'll tell you, on the low block, Valanciunas has shown that he can be a skilled offensive player, and the defense has got to pay attention to him. What a tremendous job playing through contact.
And he drops the first. So after making the first, he goes 1 for 2. Boston has got 6 out of 15 threes so far in this game. An underrated rim protector, Grant. Tice is a key component to Boston's stellar defense.
Yeah, he's really special. I mean, he has a way of blocking a lot of shots, but he also affects a lot of shots as well. Tice really understands positioning. He has great anticipation and timing. I love the surprised look on players' faces when he sends it back to him.
Pass to Allen. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot 2. First free throw is good. It's both from the stripe.
They're finding a rhythm from the line as they try to cut into this deficit.
Boston's gone 2 for 5 from three since halftime. And here's Smart. He's got 11. Outside, Brown. Counted from distance.
They're getting torched on the perimeter. 4 of the last 5 buckets have been threes.
Pass to Anderson. On the wing, Brooks. And the call will be against Jason Tatum. That's his first foul. Ja Morant, he's checked in for Jones. Valanciunas passes to Morant. 6 to shoot. Pass to Allen. Fires for 3. Good. And the setup by Morant. Allen's got 10 points.
This is as pure a shooter as there is. You've got to stay connected or it's a problem.
Now here's Thompson. Now Tatum. Count that one. He's now 5 for 8.
The assist numbers certainly stand out. They've really emphasized ball movement here today.
Out to the right wing. And out of bounds. The Celtics will take it. And here's the schedule for the Memphis Grizzlies. On Friday, they'll go up against Gordon Hayward and the Charlotte Hornets. And then on Sunday, they'll face off against Anthony Davis and the Los Angeles Lakers. Here's Smart. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot 2.
Well, that's an example of the strength of Marcus Smart. He barrels into the defense in order to pick up the foul.
And he drops the first. Teague's checked in for Thompson. Clark is checked in for Memphis. Melton comes in for Brooks. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Morant with it. Give him 8. And there's the lob. Oh, it's stolen by Tice. Outside Teague. Pass to Tice. Outside Tatum. Tice, a screen on Clark. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Jonas Valanciunas. That'll be a second foul of the game.
And that puts them just 1 foul from the bonus.
So both teams changing it up here. And stolen by Clark. Outside Morant. And there's 2. Work on the glass, paying off that time. Morant's got 10 points.
And this is something this guy takes pride in, capitalizing on second chance opportunities.
Williams finds Tatum. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
Make no mistake, this is a fundamentally sound player. Jason Tatum skilled at drawing contact.
And that one falls for Tatum.
And really strong at the line since the break.
Valanciunas, he's checked in for Memphis. And so Tatum nails both of them. The Grizzlies have gone 4 of 8 in the third. Teague against Morant. Finds it again. 6 for 12 and remaining assertive.
Well, great possession there. Anytime you end up at the rim with a high percentage look, perfect.
Outside Tatum. Now Brown. He's got 10. He got a piece of it. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession. The Celtics making a switch here. Williams is checked in. Five on the clock. Here's Teague. Again, the miss by the Celtics. The Grizzlies have gone 5 for 9 from the floor in the third quarter. Morant finds Valanciunas. And here's Clark. And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Hey, if you can't block it, sending him to the line can be the next best thing.
Down the first one. And he can't hit the second. Boston has gotten 3 of 6 threes to fall in the third quarter. Pass to Williams. Over Allen. The shot, no good. And it's Memphis the other way. From deep. They get it back.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Right wing. Now here's T. Brown with it. Picked up by Allen. And the shot goes in. Brown's got 8 here in this quarter.
I'll tell you, you have got to have a short memory. You put a poor first half behind you, and you get to work here in the second. One of the most impressive things about Jaylen Brown is his commitment to his craft. This guy actively looks to turn weaknesses into strengths. Case in point is his ball handling, guys.
Williams, a screen on Morant. Right side T. The shot won't fall.
One thing they've done well tonight, and that's rebounding.
Here's Morant.
That's a bad man right there.
Wow! B.A., forget about attempting the long-range three to cut into that lead. Just attack the rim, my man.
Man, that was sweet. Pass to Ogele. Let's the three fly. That one, no good. The Grizzlies have gone 7 of 13 in the second half. Here's Morant. The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
They're really fighting a losing battle on the glass.
The Celtics with the lead. Here's T. Outside, Williams. Oh, he tries a three. But they recover it. 1:02 left in the third quarter. 6 on the shot clock. The shot's good. Teague's got 6.
That's just toughness on display from Jeff Teague. He's scoring despite taking some pretty big-time contact.
Morant finds Valanciunas. Back to Morant.
He didn't have his feet planted.
First one falls. And the Grizzlies making a change here. Brooks has checked in. So hits one and misses one at the line. And for the Celtics, they're shooting 42% in this third quarter. Outside, Brown.
He's been tremendous at corralling misses all night long.
A lot of it comes down to great fundamentals. Establishing position early, controlling the backboards.
Pass to Melton. Shot clock at 5. Valanciunas sets a screen. And another miss by Memphis. And here's Brown. Lets it go from deep. It's good! It
did
counts
he do that?
At the buzzer!
Buzzer beater!
Woo! Wow!
That is a huge three-pointer. Extends the lead at the last possible second. That'll give him a big boost going into the fourth period.
And that'll do it for the third quarter. Celtics out in front. They're up 7. And time to step away quickly, but we'll be back in no time with the start of the fourth quarter. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Now, I know he's a big man, but he's got some point guard in him if he's making passes like this.
I'll tell you, in today's game, you want skill and decision-making at every position.
The fourth quarter has arrived. So good to have you with us. Memphis trailing here. On the court for Memphis, they've got Ja Morant. Dylan Brooks is out there with Kyle Anderson. Then it's Brandon Clark, and it's Jones in at the point guard position. Here's Clark, and he banks in the layup.
And this is just typical of him, always making an impact at crucial moments in the game.
This is a player who understands when the game is hanging in the balance. He knows it's winning time.
First one falls for him. And so Tatum nails both of them. Well, Memphis shooting only 42%. Morant, the pass to Clark. Brooks with it. Fires from deep. With the second effort. Clark, no good. The Celtics shooting around 39%. They'd like to get that higher. Back to Tatum. Just 5 to shoot. Pass to Tice. Up and over Brooks. No good. Off the front rim.
Boy, this guy just can't buy a bucket, and yet they have the advantage.
He takes it in. Jones. Rebound Boston. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Fourth quarter now. We're about a minute and a half in. Tatum from long range. Good, and that makes him 6 for 9. A quality game for him so far.
Lackluster defense, showing no desire to chase shooters off that line.
Pass to Anderson. Back to Jones. Left side, Moran. Allen, he's checked in for Moran. We're about 2 minutes into the fourth here. Pass to Allen. Ooh, Thompson with the block. And stolen by Clark. Jones with the ball. Now Allen. Clark, left side. Banked it in off the glass. Clark's got 4 points now in the quarter.
We've seen that more than once today. An effortless basket inside.
Over 2.5 minutes in the books here in the fourth. Here's Smart. Pass to Pritchard. Out of bounds. It'll be Grizzlies ball. Brown, he's checked in for Boston. Outside Jones. Pass to Brooks. There's the triple. Thompson pulls it in. Thompson's got rebound number 7 tonight. Tice with the ball. Outside Tatum. Shot clock at 6. 19-footer. It's wide right, hits off the rim. Memphis has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. Here's Jones. He buries it from 3. Jones has gotten himself going with a triple, his first basket of the game. Tatum against Brooks. Tatum passes to Brown. Jacks up a 3. The Grizzlies pull it in. Anderson's got rebound number 7 tonight. Now Jones. Pass to Clark. The shot from the low post is good. Now just a 3-point Celtic lead. And the Celtics call time here.
Things just aren't going their way. He clearly wants to talk it over.
Well, night in and night out, sometimes it's a battle of runs. Who has the most?
Valanciunas, he's checked in for Memphis. Boston has gone 1 for 2 from deep in this fourth quarter. Smart right side. It's Brown on the wing. Fades away. Got a hand on it. To the wing on the left. Brooks outside. Clock at 6. Allen with a screen on Tatum. The ball's knocked loose. Brooks from outside. And again, it's Memphis with a 3.
That's a clutch shot by a big-time shooter. And where's the D?
Pass to Thompson. Brown against Allen. Oh, they need this! Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So 2 free throws for him coming up.
And for Jaylen Brown at the free throw line, he has worked so hard on his mechanics, and that's paid dividends in terms of his confidence, guys.
He's off on the first. So So neither attempt will fall that time for him. Here's Thompson. And at last, they get one to fall.
You know, I think the activity level that Tristan Thompson plays with on missed shots is something every NBA player can learn from.
To the left side wing. Pass to Anderson. On the wing, Jones. Over Smart. And it's off the back of the rim. No good.
He expects to make every one of those, and we expect him to make them too.
A nice shot by Brown.
After an ice-cold start to this game, he is pouring it on here in the second half.
Up top, Valanciunas. Out to the right wing. He tries for three. And again, it's Memphis with a three.
This defense just can't stay connected to shooters.
The Celtics have gotten 3 of 7 attempts in this fourth quarter to fall. Tatum passes to Brown. Anderson pulls it down. Anderson's got rebound number 8 here already in the game. Here's Brown.
Oh, wow!
Hey, how about that?
We've got to get this guy in the dunk contest. Jaylen Brown taking flight with that insane athleticism.
Up top, Valanciunas. Pass to Allen. Now Jones. Brooks left side. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Brooks has got 5 points now in the quarter.
Can't ask for a better look with the game in the balance.
Smart right side. And it's rejected. Now here's Jones. Pass to Valanciunas. To the wing, right side. Here's Anderson. And again, it's the Grizzlies from deep.
Boy, that play developed just the way they wanted, and Valanciunas made sure they got the bucket. What a tremendous pass.
Smart passes to Tice. Tice sets a screen. Tatum's shot is good.
The defense can't be so relaxed at this stage of the game. Not against him.
I think he takes that kind of defense as a sign of disrespect, and he was more than happy to accept the challenge.
And now let's present our New Balance Player of the Game.
Yeah, really the standout element of this game tonight was his offense and his ability to get inside by cutting the defense to shreds, finding lanes, even making them, and relentlessly attacking the hoop.
Outside Jones. Pass to Valanciunas. On the wing, Brooks. Tice defending. It's kept alive. Now Allen. Out to the right wing. Brooks with it. 6 on the shot clock. Knocks it loose. Tatum with a steal. It's 2-on-1. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more. Falls for Tatum.
You get the sense this guy relishes getting to the free throw line in these tough moments. You talk about clutch, this guy is it.
Brooks, the pass to Valanciunas. Over Tice. Ooh, the Grizzlies with another miss. For Boston, they've gotten 6 of 12 shots to go here in this fourth quarter. Tatum against Brooks. It out to Smart. Takes the three. They grab their own miss. Blocked. For 3, Allen. The rebound, Celtics. Brown's got his 5th rebound in this one. Pass to Tatum. A minute minute 15 left in the final quarter. Memphis has gotten 4 of 7 three-pointers to fall in the fourth. Here's Brooks. And here's Brown. Down low. Thompson finds Tatum. Here's Smart. Back to Thompson. Shot clock at 5. Here's Brown. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws. That's on Jonas Valanciunas.
Boy, you have got to appreciate how hard Jaylen Brown goes. Amazing how he gets defenders to foul him when he's going up with his shot.
And no good as the first free throw misses. We'll see if he can hit the second. And he ends up missing both free throws.
They can't go empty on any of their possessions from here on out.
And no time to waste, not at this point in the game.
Brooks from outside. Yes! Oh, an enormous three-pointer!
Big-time shot, sending his teammates into a frenzy.
I'll tell you, these guys have worked so hard together, everyone pulling in the same direction. Beautiful to watch.
Just 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. Tatum against Brooks. Outside Tatum. 6 to shoot. Tice, a screen on Valanciunas. Time expires. Going to overtime. We'll take a quick break and then get you back to the action. Now we get set for overtime in what has been a stirring contest. They've got Dylan Brooks, De'Anthony Melton out there with Tyus Jones. Then there's Kyle Anderson, and it's Valanciunas in at the center position. Here's Smart. It's tipped, and they'll keep possession over Jones. And it's Smart missing.
They've been dominating the boards tonight, yet it's still a close game.
Out to the wing. Back to Jones. Pass to Brooks to take the lead. He nails it. That's his 5th make in 11 tries.
Back-to-back threes, making their defense work on the perimeter a bit.
Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
Here's Smart. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Teagues checked in for Smart. Grizzlies on D. 3-point lead. Teague attacking. Out to the right wing. Here's Tice. Yes, and a nice assist from Thompson.
Yeah, Thompson, a very good passer for a player at his position. Knows where everyone is heading.
Time called here. The Grizzlies decide to talk it over. And the Grizzlies with possession here. Valanciunas with it. Over Tice. Valanciunas can't get it to go. About 90 seconds off the clock at extra time now. Outside Tatum. The three is up. Jones grabs the board. Well, the Grizzlies shooting about 43% on this one. Back to Brooks. Tatum with a steal. Fast break. Here come the Celtics. Plenty of space. Teague. That one's good. And the Celtics lead by two.
Well, you simply cannot allow Jeff Teague any separation because the release is too good and too fast.
Pass to Melton. Let's go with a three. It's not going to go for him. And it's Boston the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Here's Tatum, and it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Valanciunas. Timeout called, the Celtics. They're leading by two. 1:43 left in the first overtime period. Here's Thompson. Outside Tatum. Good work defensively by Brooks for Memphis. They've gotten one shot to fall out of three in OT. Just over 2.5 minutes in OT in this exciting contest. The rebound by Jason Tatum. Tatum's got his 7th rebound here tonight. Pass to Brown. Going inside. And the rebound goes to the Grizzlies. Here's Anderson. Count it! A huge shot to tie it up!
Boy, the consistency he's had tonight has been impressive. Really steady from the field.
Here's Tatum. Money!
Some athleticism on display. Jason Tatum, the speed, the strides, on the drive.
Tatum against Brooks. To the paint. Here's Anderson. Yes!
Impressive one-hand slam right there, B.A.
Man, as long as he's confident about it, I'm good with it. Maybe use two hands next time. He knows where he is. Fader on the way, and it's good.
Guys, this guy is a natural-born scorer. Jason Tatum finding his groove.
And the game has come down to this. They need a score, or you can practically call it quits.
On defense, the Celtics. The lead is two. Brooks. He can't hit that time. Tice with the defensive effort. And they commit an intentional foul. We'll see another one of those, so they get into the penalty.
Getting a little desperate at this stage. I mean, the clock's the big factor.
And here are the Celtics. 2-point game. And that's an intentional foul. So the first one drops. And that makes it a 3-point lead.
Well, Jeff Teague is a very capable scorer from the lead guard position. He plays with a high motor. He can make shots. This guy is very good at the point.
So he gets them both, and it's a 4-point ball game.
Yeah, 2-possession game now after knocking both of those down.
So it's the Grizzlies now. 3-pointer, Brooks. Tice grabs the miss. And they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul.
Yeah, no choice but to foul in that situation. Although, that's not the guy you want to send to the free throw line.
He hits the first one, and that puts him up 5. And a tough break as his second attempt is no good at the line. Pass to Valanciunas. From downtown, off target.
Boy, as good as he is on the offensive end, Jason Tatum showing he can be a factor defensively.
And so it's Boston with the W. They escape with the W, even though they needed a few extra minutes to pull it off.
Yeah, and both teams gave their all. But when it came down to overtime, it was about who had more determination.
Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Allie LaForce, Grant Hill, and Doris Burke, this is Brian Anderson. Thank you for watching tonight's game. We'll see you next time.